everybody, and welcome to Time with Modi. Time with me, Modi Timekgole. If you're a returning subscriber, welcome back. I hope that you're good today. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I also hope that you're good today. And where have you been? While we're here, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and the notification bell so you can get a notification every single time I post a video. And follow me on my socials linked here. Let's be friends on social media. So I know by the title of the video, asking yourself like, how am I really doing a first year experience and the year is not over, guys? The year is technically over because, I mean, like, they're already selling Christmas decorations in shops. They're already selling Christmas hampers. Some people already have Christmas trees up, guys. The year is technically over. Guys, sorry, my voice is a bit today. Guys, just bear with me. I don't know what's going on. I'm a bit nasal. But anyway, before I went into first year, I really wish that I actually watched a first year experience video so that I knew what to expect. Because the only expectations that I had about first year are all the things that I saw on Instagram, people glowing up, people looking good, all the parties, all the fun. I thought that it was kisses and sunshine, but when I got here, it was something totally different. Before I even get into the video, this is a disclaimer. Everybody's first year experience is different, and I hope that my first year experience is able to like help somebody. And yeah, guys, I understand that everybody's first year experience is different. We all go through different things, but these are the things that I wish that I knew before first year, and these are the things that I experienced during first year. It was a really fun experience. It's a very bittersweet experience. It's an experience where you're gonna go through so many emotions. But I really can't describe the amount of emotions that I've went through this year, like good, bad. I feel like in my perspective, there was more bad than good. I don't know, but yeah, guys, let's get into the video. So to be helping me throughout this video, I have a list of things that I'm going to be talking about. Love my first experience. Don't want to show you guys my handwriting because it's not, you know, the nicest. But then yeah, let's get into the video. The very first thing that I'm going to be talking about is waiting for your matric results, guys. Nothing is more nerve-wracking than waiting for your matric results, hoping that you passed, hoping that you got distinctions, hoping that you just have a bachelor's degree passed. Guys, I feel like, yo, if only I was prepared for waiting for my matric results. And I understand, like, and I fully understand that, like, in jail, waiting for any final results is just a lot, and it's so overwhelming. And I didn't know that, like, waiting for your matric results was gonna be so nerve-wracking, and the stress that just comes with waiting for them, guys. Go to once. Yo, guys, December is really not the greatest. Quarter December, I'm not. Thinking of your matric results. When you breathe, think of your matric results, hoping that you passed. And then finally the day comes of you getting your matric results, and you're hoping that, okay, I hope that I did well. And when you see your name in the newspaper and you have a bachelor's degree, you think, what, everything is better from there, and it sparkles and sunshine. But this is where the stress begins. Stress at home no more. Cause when I'm gonna get berries and butterfly with pillow water when I'm a man. Hey, this is where all the problems begin. Then, on top of that, now you're starting to have the stress of being accepted into university and being accepted for the course that you want to do. Guys, that stress is a lot. I feel like it's more stressful because nobody prepares you for this part of events that's gonna happen. And it's like, oh my gosh, it was such a stressful situation. And it also hurts so much when like your friends are telling you like, oh my gosh, I've been accepted into this university, and you're still waiting for a university acceptance. And this is like the harsh truth, like, oh my gosh, waiting for university acceptance is so, just a lot of stress that you just need to go through, guys. If only I was prepared for the stress. I feel like you can never be prepared for any stressful situation in life. As much as anybody can tell you about a stressful situation, but then you just cannot be prepared for that stressful situation. I don't know, this is me personally. Next thing that I had to experience, well, that I learned, it's experienced in my first year. This is like where like first year really starts, is once you have been accepted to university, you think that everything is glitters and slush, and you're like, okay, I'm going into a new environment, I'm really excited. You know, I feel like having a fresh start, well, for me personally, I thought that, you know what, having a fresh start, making new friends, really sounded like a good idea, because I was really excited. I'm like, okay, I'm gonna have new friends, new environment, new everything. But then when I got there, I was actually overwhelmed. It actually took me so long to be able to adjust to the fact that I'm actually in a new environment and being able to adjust with all the new routines and all the freedom that I had. And people are like, oh my gosh, but then like when you're living on your own, you have so much freedom. Guys, freedom sounds like a lot of fun, but then, you know, it really depends and differs on a person and how each and every person is able to deal with freedom. And being responsible for yourself, guys. Here you're really being responsible for yourself. There's no mommy. Okay, I understand, like, when it comes to your parents, like, you're able, like, they're still responsible of you, like, financially, and you still see them when you go home. But I feel like for me personally, me and my mom have always been close, and I feel like this year has really, like, really brought us closer together. Even people that weren't as close to their parents are much more closer to their parents now, because they're in first year and they're spending, like, a lot of time away from their families. But then you really, like, you really become a responsibility of yourself. You need to always make sure that you're eating, you always need to make sure that you're having the right amount of sleep, that you're studying. Like, you really just, like, the, like, now I understand how it feels like to be a parent. The skill that I have this year is actually being able to make friends. Even now, in a whole October, I mean, nearing to the end of the year, I'm still finding it difficult to make friends. Just to make friends that, like, or people, or communicate with people that are able to understand me. Because my problem and my downfall was when I was trying to make friends, I was trying to look for things that I already had, like certain groups or people that I already have. Like, let's say, for example, in high school, I was the only girl in my squad. I was trying to look for that same group dynamic, and I was able to find it. And really took me so long to accept Horido, to new friends, and being able to know people more. Like, guys, it was really overwhelming for me. I just don't know. Like, I really find it so difficult for me to make friends. I didn't understand, like, how am I finding it so difficult to make friends? Even my friends don't understand, like, how I'm finding it difficult to make friends, guys. I'm really finding it so difficult to make friends. Another thing that I learned, like, or like one thing that I had to experience, is being broke, guys. And your money goes out as fast as it comes in, guys. I promise you, if you do not know how to handle money, your money's gonna go away like this. I feel like it's even more stressful for people that have to buy groceries, and people that have to, you know, buy, because I know that some people are paying for their own electricity and gas, depending on the rate that you're staying on. But people that have to buy their own electricity and also buy their own groceries, their money vanishes. And it's more frustrating than paying for transport, because you don't see where your money is going. Like, your money is literally there one day, and then the next day you don't have any money, and that is so frustrating. Like, I promise you, that's the stress that I had, that my money would just vanish. I'd literally have money today, and then tomorrow I don't have any money. Like, guys, I feel like one thing I've learned is being able to be savvy with your money, and being able to learn how to take care of your money and how to manage your money. It took me time to be able to learn how to manage my money. Still at the end of the month, I still wouldn't be happy, like, oh my gosh, I have this much left. But then, guys, learning how to be savvy with your money. That I've experienced or learned is that I actually learned how to cook this year. Crazy. I know that it's so crazy at my grown age, I don't know how to cook. But things, when I lived back at home, the oven was literally my best friend. Like, every single thing that I would cook, I made in the oven. Every single thing that I would make in the oven. And then when I got to rest, I had a reality check, and when I got there, there was no oven, and I had to learn how to cook. And I remember my very first meal, I made mincemeat, and yo, guys, that meal, go to the thought of that meal, my blood shivers. But then I feel like as time is going by, I'm actually learning how to cook. I can't say that I'm the best cook, but my cooking is getting good. Just as the way, like, you know, when you're learning how to drive, every single time you get into the car, you're learning how to drive. Also, me, every single time I go to the store and I'm making a meal, I'm improving and I'm learning how to cook, and I'm, you see, like, I'm learning new things. Another thing that I've come to terms with is gaining weight. Guys, gaining weight is a thing. I didn't ever think that I'd be able to, you know, gain weight, because I got here and my eating habits are just rubbish. I ate a whole lot of rubbish because of the environment that I lived in. I became lazy. Everything was just a mess, and I started to eat rubbish. And then I started to accept the fact that, oh my gosh, I'm actually gaining weight. And what I did when second semester started, because I didn't like the fact that I gained so much weight in first semester, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna join the soccer team so that, you know, I can try and get back to my old body weight, and also try and keep fit, and also change my eating habits, because, guys, I did not like my weight. It was just a mess, shambles, yo. Guys, it was just a lot. But I'm actually happy that now I was able to maintain my eating habits. But I feel like everybody's different. Some people might gain, some people might lose. But me personally, I gained and I just did not like it. And remember that you're really not forced to join a sport. If you want to join a sport, you can join it. If you don't want to, you don't have to. If you want to go to the gym, you can go to the gym. I just opted not to go to the gym because I'm like, the gym is a lot of money that I do not want to waste, and money that I do not have. So let me join soccer because that is free, and, you know, it's like a group activity and everybody's able to motivate each other. Okay, so another thing that I'm going to be talking about, another thing that I learned, is guys, the workload, the amount of workload that you get in first year and the amount of workload that you get in high school are two different things, and it really does take you a while to adjust to the amount of workload that you had. Because I only had, for example, first semester we had like 5 modules, and in matric we had 7 or 6 subjects, and I thought that I was gonna be able to manage it much more quickly, and I was like, okay, everything's gonna go well because I have fewer modules now. And it wasn't like that, like it really wasn't like that, because the workload is just so much. And I feel like the sad thing here is that they don't tell you exactly what to study, they don't tell you all these things, and you really need to figure these things out on your own. And you know, you need to not study, you need to be prepared for all the cross tests that are gonna happen, you just need to be prepared for each and every single thing that's gonna be thrown your way. Like, guys, this thing has really come with a lot of emotions. But academics, one thing I've learned is that academics will really humble you in your first year. And I really couldn't understand, like, how, you know, I really thought that my academics were gonna be top notch, best of the best, because I'm doing a course that I wanna do, and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna be able to get marks higher than high school. But guys, academics will humble you. Every single thing. Go to when this academic stress, everything in your life just starts, you know, things aren't adding up. Your skin isn't fine, you're not fine, you're mental. Like, guys, your academics will really humble you. Like, the academic stress that I've been through this year, and the academic stress that I'm still going through because exams are coming. But like, guys, even though you feel like, oh my gosh, like, you know, back in high school, if you used to get good marks, now you're gonna look at your marks and be like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna get the same marks, my marks are lower. Guys, trust me, you're gonna be able to bounce back, even though you just feel so demotivated because of the marks that you get in. But trust me, you'll be able to bounce back. But academic stress will really humble you. Also, depending on the course that you're doing, then academics are pushing through. I hope that academics is my best friend now. Like, guys, I just hope that things get better. The thing that I've learned is that when it comes to time management, you need to know how to manage your time. Okay, one thing that I learned is, like, managing your time, like being able to manage your schoolwork, being able to manage your social life, being able to manage your academics, being able to manage everything else in between, like the parties, going out, you know, anything. Like, guys, just need to, like, you really just need to know how to manage your time. I feel like as time goes along throughout your first year, you're gonna be able to manage your time, because at the beginning, like, things are uneven. But then there comes a point where, like, okay, now I see, okay, let me manage my academics, and let me manage my social life and whatnot. So I feel like things are able to get better as time goes by throughout your first year. And then another thing that I have learned throughout my first year is that you really need a very good support system throughout your whole first year. Like, people that are going to support you through each and every single decision that you make, and even people that are going to support you through all the academic decisions and through academic stress that you go through. And a lot of people, like, might be like, oh my gosh, who's gonna support me, guys, as much as everybody's going through their own problems. But you really just need a very good support system, and also need to be a very good support system to the people around you, whether it be your mom or your sister or your friends from home or your friends. They just need a very good support system, because, like, there are really times where you just feel like you can't do this anymore, and you just need that push to able to, like, you know what, make you believe and do the best that you can do. If you're someone, okay, I got this, I can do this, you know what, like, guys, you really need, like, a very good support system. And I'm so grateful and thankful for the support system that I have, and people that are able to push me to do the best that I can do. The importance of friendship. So, guys, the importance of friendship, okay, you really learn the importance of friendship in terms of the friends that you make this year and the friends that you also make at home. Something I realized is that most of the friends that you made back at home or back in high school weren't actually your friends. They were just your friends because you guys associated around the same people back in high school, or you guys were friends because you guys were in the same classes in high school, or you guys were basically in the same high school. But then over here, you really learn the importance of friendship, and you really understand and see who is really for you. Like, I really, like, went through the pits of friendship. Could have been on an adventure with friendships this year. Like, I've seen it all, I've dealt it all, guys. And, like, one thing that I really learned, the importance of friendship, I also learned that, like, people are gonna disappoint you. Like, so many people are gonna disappoint you. Like, I remember that I was unable to deal with all the disappointments that would come to my way. Like, you find that I have plans with people, And everybody would just be like ditching me, like, oh my gosh, we can't do this, we can't see you, whatnot, whatnot. And it would really hurt me, and I'd cry, like, oh my gosh, nobody wants to see me, whatnot, whatnot. I feel like with the importance of friendship, you also learn how to deal with disappointment. And nobody wants to, like, accept Jorge. You really get disappointed most of the time, but then matter of a fact is that you're gonna have to deal with all the disappointment that's gonna come your way. Even though you don't want to hear it, but then, like, that is just the truth of the reality, that you're gonna have to deal with all the disappointment that comes your way. I'm actually really, like, you really learn who you are as a person. I thought that the person that I was in with Chick is who I really am, but then when you're in first year, you actually really learn who you really are, because you're exposed to things that you weren't really exposed to back in high school. You really get time, like, you really have time to yourself, able to figure out who you really are, and, like, proud of the growth that I've made throughout the months, because I know that, like, growth doesn't stop, but I'm so grateful for the growth that I've made throughout the months. In terms of all the people that I've met, and all the friends that I've made, and all the decisions that I've made, and learn so much about yourself, and you really know what goals you want to achieve, who you are as a person, and where you want to be in life, guys. You really learn so much about yourself. The thing that I want to talk about is the parties. I feel like when it comes to the parties, it differs from where you stay and what university you're in, because we all have different types of parties, and people might be going to the clubs, others might be going to actually, like, house parties or chill houses. And I feel like the parties that I went to were the parties, like, that were at Res. Those are, like, the parties that I spent, like, most of my time at, and also the parties that happened, like, at school, like the freshers that happened and the ones that orientation had. And I wasn't the type of person to, like, you know, go to, like, the club life, and not, like, the club scene isn't for me. I don't know, maybe, like, everybody else is different, but, like, the club scene really wasn't for me, so I wouldn't prefer going to, you know, parties at the club and whatnot, whatnot. But I feel like when it came to the parties were quite extreme, they were hectic, they were a lot, guys. Think about, like, the parties that I've been to, they have been a lot. They have been so much fun, I don't wanna lie. So much fun, and they've really been, like, so draining. But you really enjoy the parties, and you really just, when it comes to the parties, honestly, you really just need to know how to manage your party life, your academic life, your social life, each and every single thing. You just need to know how to manage it, because, wow, it really does get draining, and you really must have focused on going all too well to all these parties and not focusing on your academic life, because it's really gonna strain your academics. Like, you're really gonna feel it, and it's not it, guys, trust me, if you only focus on the parties and not on your academics, it's not cute. I've learned in my first year experience, and I also asked people what they learned in their first year experience, or, like, what their first experience was like. Somebody told me that with their first experience, that if you believe in God, like, you really also grow with God, and that is no lie, guys, because you really start to, like, you know, through all the things that you go through, He's the only one that is able to really understand you, and you really grow, like, a very good relationship with God. Those are all the things that I learned in my first experience that I wish that I was able to, like, you know before. And I really hope that this video actually helps somebody that's going in to first year next year, or somebody that's gonna be applying with their grade 11 marks, like grade 11s and matrix. I know that you guys are already writing your exams, but I hope that this video is able to help you guys. And guys, good luck to everybody who's also writing exams, and anybody who's also in first year, drop down a comment on how your first year experience was and what you learned. Maybe I've missed out something, because as I stated earlier, we all have different first year experience. And I hope that everybody has a good week ahead, hope that everybody studies well, and guys, can we all just try and maintain our anxiety? I know that, like, it sounds like a myth, but then, like, can we just all try and maintain our anxiety, and just know what, like, we're literally at the end of the year, the final stretch, and then December, and guys, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to comment down below, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, and I hope to see you guys in my next video. Bye.